time, I traveled all the way from Lusaka yesterday to come and register as a voter. I do believe that we all have where we come from, and I didn't think it was important for me to register from Lusaka. I needed to come and register. At the best, you know that my political career started from Ron, and I felt it was very, very important that I come and register in Ron, where people supported me all this long that I've been as MP, that I've been in politics. And I want to urge all the Zambians, please, I know that the process is a bit tedious, it's a bit slow, because like here, there is only one person doing the process. I expected that maybe we should have had three or five, six machines that, you know, the registration offset should have been about six. But nevertheless, my encouragement is that please register in masses. And those who think that, no, look, we are suffering, we've been voting for a long time and there's no change, you are the change. And if you don't vote, it simply means you are accepting of everything that is, you know, obtaining. We urge you to come and register as a voter so that you can make a difference and choose leaders of your choice. This idea of voter apathy should come to an end, because when there is voter apathy, usually those in government take advantage, and that's when there can be some manipulation. But when a lot of people come out to vote, a lot of people come out to register, then you see that the leaders that are going to be chosen will be the leaders of the choice of the people. So it's important, I urge the people of Ron, I urge the people of Zambia, that please come out, register to vote. Your vote is your voice. That's the only way you contribute to the development of this country. And I want to urge the Electoral Commission of Zambia, we have said, and I want to say it again, that the 30 days that you have voted is not enough to capture even $2 million, even 2 million voters. It's not possible, even 1 million voters. Please extend the voter registration. If you cannot extend the voter registration, my appeal is that put more machines. For instance, here we should have at least 10 people or 10 officers doing the registration. Then you can beat the 9 million voters that you have. And then this idea of moving from one polling station to the other after 7 days should not be the case. You promise that you station officers at each and every polling station for 30 days. And you were saying in 30 days, if each polling station registers 33 people, then you will meet the 9 million. But again, you have changed. You are saying they should be only, they should be at one polling station for 7 days and they move. Sure, what are you trying to do, Electoral Commission of Zambia? Are you trying to disenfranchise the people of Zambia? Or what game are you playing? Because as far as I'm concerned, you are now playing games and you're not being serious. Please let as many people as possible register to vote. It is their right. It is their constitutional right. So my appeal to you is that please sort out this mess. One registration machine at a go is not anything to go by. And I am told that in some instances, there are 40 machines. Please, can you have technicians on site or even standby machines so that when there is a fault, you quickly move to a standby machine. But the ideal thing would be that at every polling station, there must be more than five machines for registration. This time is a farming season. People want to go to Mabala. They depend on farming. Now, to keep them on the queue for a long time is a counterproduction for the country. So I am glad that I've registered to vote and I'll participate in the vote. And it is your right, it is also your responsibility as a Zambian to come and register.